If you think there's nothing to do in Newcastle and Lawrence County, then think again. Always stay connected to NCTV45 to receive the information on events going on in and around the area on a daily basis. Programs to view are NewsWatch, The Morning Show, and Community Happenings. NCTV45 takes pride in bringing you the event and organization info that you want. NCTV45 is the number one media source locally. NCTV45, anytime, on your time.
Entrusting your loved one to a funeral director is a very personal and emotional decision. The funeral director you choose must understand the importance of the decision you have made. When you call the William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home, I recognize what a privilege it is to be chosen at your time of need. We will provide you and your family with the best service possible, with sincerity and compassion.
The William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home, family owned and operated since 1941.
Welcome to NewsWatch. Yesterday's story about Pennsylvania's unemployment rate dropped to 4% in February. The state has issued a revised statement that was 6 of 11 super sectors added jobs during the month. So I wanted to make note of that. Meanwhile, also in state news, the Department of Health earned National Public Health Accreditation. The Pennsylvania Department of Health achieved National Public Health Accreditation on Monday, demonstrating the department's continued commitment to protecting and improving the health and safety of Pennsylvanians. This is a very important milestone in our contributed efforts to promote healthy lifestyles, prevent injury and disease, and to assure the safe delivery of quality health care in Pennsylvania, said Secretary of Health Dr. Rachel Levine. Each day we're working to address health issues in a wide range of areas, including ensuring Pennsylvania's health, healthy moms and healthy kids protecting seniors in nursing homes and addressing the opioid crisis. We are committed to working towards a healthy Pennsylvania. Now, we're going to take this break on NewsWatch. We'll return right after these messages.
NCTV 45, Newcastle, The Train.
Today's program was provided through funding from Coney Island, Coney Island Downtown in downtown Newcastle, a Newcastle tradition. Hello and welcome back on NewsWatch. Now, it was announced yesterday, and this is interesting, that there's going to be a hosting of Meet the Candidate. New Visions and the Newcastle News are having a Meet the Candidate, Republicans on April 16th and Democrats on April 30th. The events will be held at the Confluence from 6 to 8. This is not a debate, but a chance for the candidates to talk to all folks about themselves, their platforms, and what they think, and answer questions. Now, interesting that we've had Meet the Candidate for some time, and I congratulate everybody on getting the word out as the Hoyt had Meet the Candidate, and now there's a Meet the Candidate at the Confluence. So once again, that's April 16th and April 30th. The 16th for Republicans, April 30th for Democrats, and that will be from 6 to 8. Now, make sure you show up, make sure you're informed, and by all means, make sure you vote. We're going to take this break on NewsWatch. We'll return right after these messages.
NCTV 45, Newcastle, The Train. Parkstown Restaurant has been serving the greater Newcastle area with quality and experience in family dining and great entertainment. The Parkstown Restaurant, located at 2800 West State Street, Newcastle. Eat in or take out.
These fine businesses provided funding for this program. Gatherings, Town and Country, and On Target.
Keeping you informed. Now, the Knights of Columbus, this is from Brian Frank, had a scheduled meeting for Wednesday, March 27th. That meeting has at St. Mary's has been canceled. The social meeting will still take place at 7:30 on Wednesday the 27th. So just know that there'll be no meeting at 7 o'clock. Now, PennDOT announces the next steps in a public-private partnership targeting environmental preservation. The Pennsylvania Department of Transportation Secretary Leslie Richards today announced that three teams will be invited to submit proposals for a program to preserve 140 acres of PennDOT-owned land in Berks County through a private public-private partnership, P3. The land will be transferred into site capable of providing credits for PennDOT and private development projects. So that in from the state, and we wish them luck. Now we're going to take a break here from these great sponsors who keep community television on the air for you. Program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. The Cedar Sports Corner. Yes, as you go into Tuesday in the NBA, the Spurs will be taking on the Hornets, while the Celtics, they visit the Cavaliers. Over in later games, it's the Bulls at the Raptors, Magic at the Heat. The Rockets take on the Bucks. The Clippers take on the Timberwolves, the Hawks, the Pelicans, and the Kings take on the Mavericks. The Pistons will be at the Nuggets, and the Wizards will take on the Lakers. Now in the NHL, as we inch ever closer to April and playoff hockey, the Hurricanes are at the Capitals, Islanders are at the Blue Jackets, the Panthers, they'll be taking on the Canadiens, while the Sabres take on the Senators. Kings will be at the Oilers, Ducks at the Canucks, and Blackhawks, they'll be at the Coyotes. And let's get to Major League Baseball. And we're inching closer to opening day. Pirates, they're visiting the Astros while the Indians take on the Texas Rangers. Detroit will be at Tampa Bay. And the White Sox will be at the Diamondbacks. Reds will be at the Braves. Red Sox will be at the Cubs. And the Rockies, they'll be at the Twins. Now, this was the Cedars Sports Corner. Head over to Cedars, get some great food. Enjoy that. Wings and a favorite beverage. And, hey, watch the game. We'll be right back after we take this timeout.
NCTV45, Newcastle, The Train.
Today's program furnished by funding from Bill's Big Shop, where smiles are everywhere. This program furnished by a grant from Ferrone Brothers. Two locations, Newcastle on Mill Street and Wilmington Road in Newcastle. This program furnished by a grant from Keystone Specialty, Newcastle's party store on Mill Street in Newcastle.
And we received an update on the GOP event on April 16th. They were having a meet the candidate at the Confluence, and it says the moderator will be Warren Youngstown's Regional Chamber of Commerce for GOP candidates that include the mayor of Newcastle School Board. This will be on April 16th from 6 to 8, and they will have a moderator there. This has been sent. Apparently, it's not a debate, but they talked about this as, I don't know what you're going to moderate, as people ask questions. Maybe they want a seated audience. So just wanted to get you up on that. So it won't be like the way it was at the Hoyt, where you're just actually talking to the candidates. I guess they're going to have an audience setting. We'll keep you informed. We'll be right back after these messages.
NCTV45, Newcastle, The Train.
Program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars. featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. A special thanks to the YMCA for caring about the Lawrence County community and providing funding for this program. A special thank you to Tuscany Square Restaurant, Wilmington and Mitchell Roads, for providing funding for this program.
Welcome back, and NewsWatch reminding you about Western Pennsylvania's Patriot Bash. Now, this will be hosted by BW Unlimited Charity Fundraising and the Warrior Music Foundation. Friday, May 17th, 7 to 11 p.m. at the Scottish Rite Cathedral in Newcastle. Now, we've told you about this before. You've been invited. We ask you to purchase your tickets and support this worthy cause. May 17th, make sure you write and mark that down on your calendar. And we hope to see you at the Patriot Bash. We'll return right after these messages.
Tuscany Square Restaurant, 3470 Wilmington Road, where old world charm meets the modern conveniences of today. Spacious seating and amenities await. Fresh ingredients that make that just right pizza or entree. It's Tuscany Square for your next event. Stop and see us or give us a call at 724-654-0365.
Lawrence County 45 weather, and after last night's clear low of 24, how does your Tuesday look? Well, as you look at local radar off to the south and east, you see some ground clutter. And then looking to the north and the west on the national scene, especially direct west, you see clear skies. So Tuesday, this is going to be a picture day, sunny 47. Tuesday night, mostly clear and 22. Wednesday, sunny and 55. Wednesday night, mostly clear and 33. Thursday, partly sunny, 61. Thursday night, mostly cloudy, 44. And Friday rolls along. Cloudy and 59, 80% chance of rain. And that rain continues in Friday night, cloudy, 44. Chance of rain, 50%. Now, your Saturday, showers, cloudy, 61, 60% chance of rain. Saturday night, rain likely, mostly cloudy, 35, 70% chance, and some of that rain and precipitation could be in the form of wet snow. Sunday, partly sunny and 47. Sunday night, mostly cloudy and 31, and Monday, mostly sunny and 49. Now that was Lawrence County 45 weather, and we're going to take this break and hear from these great sponsors who keep community television on the air for you.
Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV45. And NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station.
NCTV 45, Newcastle, the train.
This program furnished by the MAD Unit, Mobile Auto Detailing. See Michael Sad at themadunit.com. This program furnished by Sporting Goods, 23 East Washington Street, Newcastle. Call 724-658-2535. Funding for this program furnished by Mary's Turner's Day Spa, Wilmington Road, Neshannock Township, Newcastle.
As NewsWatch rolls on, yes, spring thaws prompt fire safety tips from the state fire commissioner. Now, with the spring thaw and warmer temperatures, Bruce Trago is offering Pennsylvanians seasonal fire tips to assist them in the annual spring cleanup chores. Winter can be tough on homes, okay, but don't let the excitement get in the way of thinking smart decisions about fire safety. Spring is a great time to start thinking about the necessary precautions that should be taken around and outside the home to protect against fire-related hazards and the dangers of house fires. Inside the home, it is important to think about removing hazardous fire materials. Test your home's smoke detector, carbon monoxide detector. Discontinue the use of electrical appliances that have frayed cords. Okay, it goes on to say remove dead leaves and other flammable debris from around the foundation, under the deck, porches, and stairs, just to name a few. Now, these great sponsors, they keep community television on the air, and they'd like to hear from you.
At our law firm, we see you. Come see us at lgkg.com.
Peppers, mouth-watering fruit, fine dressings, apples, meats. This place looks so familiar, everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
There's more than meets the eye. You gotta give them a Newcastle a try. The right small town for living. Look around.
NCTV 45, The Train. Anytime on your time.
Well, that's going to do it for this Tuesday. Thanks for tuning in to NCTV45's Nightly News. We appreciate your viewership, your sponsorship, and the fact that we know you tell a friend about NCTV 45. It makes us feel good inside, and I'm sure it does the same for them. Now, make sure you have a pleasant evening in what I call the greatest castle in the world, in the County of Lawrence. We'll see you again tomorrow. Good night.
Got my ticket for the midnight plane, and it's not easy.